Notion just released a brand new database view called Feed View. I'm so excited to share about this update because now we have another way to visualize our data. In this video, I'll go over how to add the Feed View, settings, and my thoughts on various use cases for this new view. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's dive right in. Let's first go over how to add a Feed View database. To add a feed view, it's just like any other database. You can type /feed and then you can simply add that database in plus new empty database, and it's going to look something like this. What feed view looks like is that it acts kind of like your feed. It works in one column, which is different from the other database types like gallery view, while still showing elements of what's inside of each page. Let's say that I have my new feed here and I add a new page inside, then you can see that it already starts adding information like this. Now, if I add something inside of this feed view, so I can go open and side peek, say that I add some text here, then you can see the text inside here. I can even add images, and it's going to show up here as well. It has a very nice view in the sense that you can actually just read the information directly from the main page without having to open that database page. Another way that you can create feed views is that, let's say you have a current table view like this. Let's say that you have various tasks. You want to change this task database and you want to add a new empty view, and I want this one to be in feed view. You can do something like this. So you have your table view here, and then you have a feed view over here. And you can also transform this into a page. So just like other databases, you can see it as a database page like this as well. Next, let's talk about various settings. With the feed view database, you can access your settings by going to this settings icon here. And just like other databases, you can go to layout and then adjust various things. With the feed view, you can decide to show or hide page icon, just like all the other ones. You can also toggle author byline. So this is different from all the other ones. If you toggle this, you don't know who wrote this entry here. It's useful if you have things like announcements or even like a blog, then it could be useful to have that author byline at the top so you know who wrote it. You can choose how the page is open and the load limit here. So now if I go back to the layout settings, the other thing I wanted to showcase is the property visibility. So just like other database views, you can adjust property visibilities. And what that means is that, let's say that I have a multi-select like this and I choose the name tag, and then I'm going to add, let's say this is a task. Then I can go to my settings here and then go to property visibility and turn on task like this. And what I've noticed with feed view is that it usually adds all of the properties into rows. So the more properties you have visualized here, it's gonna just show them all in the top part here. Then the next thing I wanted to show is the filter. So just like other ones, you can filter it. So let's say you only wanna see tasks, then it's gonna do this. And then the next one is very important, and that is the sort feature. So I'm going to talk about this one a bit more later on in this video, but you can sort it by the name, you can sort it by the tag. So any property you have, you can sort it by. And with the case of feed view, I would really recommend having a date property so that you can manage that using the sort feature. And then the next setting that I wanted to cover is something that's a little bit more hidden. As you see this comment here where you can make new comments. If you don't want this to be a part of your feed view, you can remove this by going to the customize layout. And then what you can do is go to the page discussions and you can turn this one off. So if you do this, then what happens is now we won't see the option to make comments underneath. It does give a very clean layout. And we can even go further by removing the author byline, and it's going to look something like this. Next, let's talk about use cases for feed view. And for this, I wanted to first take a task database, which I'm sure many of you have in your Notion workspaces. So if you have some kind of task database, you could add a feed view as an additional view where you could organize your feed view by the date it was updated. This way you can visualize what's getting updated inside of your task database. To do this, I would recommend adding a property like last edited time. So then you can have a date here that timestamps it, and then you can sort this last edited time, save for everyone. And then you can also show that last edited time here so you can see that timestamp. So we can now see that this one was 943 and this one was 950. And for this, the best way is to do descending so that you see the last edited one here. So let's say that I actually edited this task. I changed it to task like this, then it's going to now be at the very top as the last edited time. So you can always see what's going on in your task databases. This is also useful because you can add comments underneath as well if you want to note things down for your team members. The next one I wanted to show is announcements. You can also think of this as a blog. I think that this is also where feed view can really shine. So I'm going to add a new feed view here, / feed view, and then new empty database. And let's say that these are announcements, and I'll add one here, new office location. We can add a property. Let's say that this one is a date property, announcement date. Then we can add another property, let's say multi-select, and we want this to be tagged, and we'll say office here. And then we can fill this in with various information. So now let's say that we have this announcement about a new office location. Then I can click out like this, and it's going to look something like this with the new office location and the picture. You can read the article by clicking through here. You can add comments. In that sense, this is a really nice announcement style feed or blog style feed that you can add as well, that gives another dimension that you couldn't get with, let's say, gallery view, where you see only a small portion of inside of that database page. You can now go to property visibility, turn on tags, turn on the date as well, and we can move that like this. And then I would recommend, again, turning on the sort for the date so that you see your newest ones at the top. This could be a really nice addition to, let's say, your company homepage, where all of your team works together to share announcements. The next one I wanted to showcase for the feed view is a daily checklist. So this is more if you want to use it personally rather than as a team. Then one way that I think feed view is going to be really useful is if I add a new feed view, and this is my daily checklist. And I could add a database template here, daily checklist. And let's say that I also put a pin icon here so it looks nicer. And after that, I'm going to put some checklists like this. And then let's say drink water, and you always have the same daily checklist. So now if I click out and I set this one as a default like this, then every time I add a new daily checklist, it's going to load my checklist like this, and I can open this up and check them off as I go throughout my day and still see it up top here. And for this one, I would recommend hiding the author byline and also to add a date property so that it's going to sort it correctly. So I'm going to put also a date here, and let's say it's today. And then I can also showcase that, going to property visibility, and I'm going to sort this by date, descending, and then save. So now if I add another one, and let's say this one was from the 19th, then I'll see it down here. So you can see a day-to-day checklist of what you need to do. And I think this is really useful, so you can see in your workspace. Also, if you have, let's say, two columns, this could be a nice sort of widget type thing that you have on the side that you can see. So let's say that I hide this database title, and now it's a very minimal look with your daily checklist in feed view. What are your thoughts on feed view? Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I hope to see you all in the next video.